Hi guys, my name is Hugo. Today let's talk about something very important in narrative filmmaking that is very often underestimated by beginner filmmakers. It's called blocking. Blocking refers to how one or more actors move around the space during the production. In simple words, it's a rehearsal on the actual place of shooting. But blocking isn't simply where the actors move through the scene, it's also how they interact with their environment. This can include body language, might include moving props, vehicle, and multiple locations. It's important for actors and directors to understand the power of performing blocking. When a first-time director steps on the set, blocking a scene can be one of the most frustrating and terrifying parts of their job. If a director doesn't understand the concept of blocking and staging, and they also don't know how to speak the actor's language, they could end up wasting valuable shooting time. And shooting a lot more takes that it could possibly done with a proper blocking. And I know that shooting the digital just takes a space on your hard drives and may not be a big deal. But I'm a firm believer that even if we shoot digital, we still have to treat the camera as we shoot on an expensive film. This way you'll get the most output from actors' performances and the best focus from the camera crew. It'll make a lot easier for editors to pull all together, and of course, it'll save tons of valuable time on set. Cinematographers work hand to hand with directors on blocking because cinematographer is one who's gonna help to place actors and camera in the best relation to lights and environment. Most of times DPs are more experienced than directors who hired them, probably simply because they can rely on them. DPs can be their safety bag in resolving puzzles like blocking. Here are 5 important blocking tips. 1. Having a shot list or storyboard will help you during the blocking process. Many directors can work without storyboard because they have a strong vision in their head of how it has to be done. But I think it's very selfish, since making a film it's a team effort, and the storyboard it's a tool that helps directors to communicate, explaining to the cast and the crew his vision, so everyone can be on the same page, which also helps to move faster. The shot list is like a map, it gives you a path to your destination. 2. Let the actors show what they want to do first, then you make a suggestion. It is based on something that you have already seen. Sometimes actors can give you a better performance when they have a freedom to express themselves the way they feel right. But you always have the ability to adjust or change anything if something doesn't work for you. Once blocking is confirmed, cinematographer and gaffer can lead the location the best possible way in relation to the actors. 3. Camera movements and placement. Usually it's 2 scenarios: to place actors based on where the camera gonna be when you have a strict storyboard and vision, or placing and moving camera based on how the actor is gonna move in the scene. In both ways, where the camera is gonna be placed determined primarily by what is important in a scene. 4. Directors need to keep working on blocking until the whole scene works. It's like a choreography of a dance or a ballet. All the elements on the set, actors, extras, vehicles, crew, equipment should move in perfect harmony with each other. You are not gonna need to shoot many takes when everything is perfectly rehearsed. 5. In television and low-budget films, speed is essential. Story and block some scene so that your action takes place in one direction to avoid turning the camera around for reverses, crossing 180-degree lines, unless it's intended. After mastering all the steps, you'll add 2 more advanced steps. One is how to direct audience's eyes to where you want them to look and what you want them to feel. You want the audience to understand the tension and the deeper meaning of each frame. And 2, staging and production design made specifically for a message and the story of your scene and film. Pretty much building stage and using specific furniture, lights, props and etc. that helps you to tell your story. But these advanced steps come only with experience and bigger productions and budgets. Only after all those 5 basic steps are no-brainer anymore. To me personally, it took about 5-6 years before I actually started thinking about deeper meaning of camera moving, framing and lighting to tell the story. Maybe you don't need to spend that much time, probably it depends on the quantity of narrative projects you've done. But it'll definitely take some time. I had to go through lots of mistakes in every single step I listed above, and I failed many times before I succeeded. But hopefully, this kind of guidance will help you to speed up the process and help you to understand all sooner than I did. That's why I wanted to share this info, and I hope it'll be useful for you. Thank you for your time. Bye.